expecting the worst. Are you gonna drop the bomb or not? Let us die young or let us live forever. We don't have the power, but we never
say hello.
So come listen to our station live at webradio.com.
Mitchie T-shirt.
With music, news, sports, whatever your taste is, it's there. Web Radio also has some cool giveaways on.
For your auto repairs, including expert collision work, LA Radiator on Santa Monica Boulevard is the place to go. Located just a few steps east of Vine, LA Radiator offers the fastest service at the lowest cost available anywhere in the area. Whether it's just a tune-up or a major repair, you'll be putting your car in the best possible.
I'll take 17.
LA Radiator fool you. They do a lot more.
Don't let it fool you now.
Just a car, Terry? It's a climbing from the ceiling of my garage so I don't run into the wall?
Exactly.
I'm more technologically advanced than that, Terry.
Oh.
The ultrasonic parking alert from Radio Shack with signal lights
on the phone.
To tell you when to
on
stop
the phone. I'm always on the phone.
One of many cool things you don't even know you need, like the digital tire gauge, just $11.99. Radio Shack.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen. You're listening to me, Mitchie T. Yes. That is right. What you've all been waiting for. Yes, it's Thursday, 6:30. It's time for me, your favorite DJ, Mitchie T, right here on KLAS 89.7 FM. Yes, that's FM. Yes, where you can call in. Yes, you need to want to call in because it's 323-962-1937. Do call in, but please be nice over the airwaves. We've had some coincidence. And yes, out there, I know you're listening, and yes, watching, because it's more than just music, it's more than just radio. This is the Mitchie T Show, and yes, we have some special guests today. Go ahead and say hello to all Hollywood and the rest of the world. Go ahead and say hello to the mic, talking
hello,
to the mic.
Hello, Hollywood and the rest guys. Of the world.
Wait, go ahead and do tell who exactly you are.
Oh, who?
Yes.
Wow.
The lovely, star-stunning Tiara.
Actually, it's pronounced Tiara, but I always make that mistake.
Of course, I'm a mistake maker, so.
No, but it's actually a frequent mistake. Everyone's like, Tiara, Tiara. I actually dated a guy for a year who...
You dated a guy? No way. I thought you were into girls.
No. Listen, his entire family thought my name was Tiara, and I was too shy back then to be like, my name's Tiara. So I just dealt with it for a whole year.
Tiara.
Then I broke up with him, and I was like, well, screw you. My name's Tiara.
Oh, I like that. Tiara, and who's your friend over here? The shy one.
Jess.
Yeah.
The fabulous Jess.
Let's see, everyone's got a nickname around here. You're gonna get your nickname too if you tune in. We get your nickname. So, you two. Wow. You two.
Trouble.
Yeah, double trouble.
Crime,
partner in crime. T squared. Yes, T squared it up. And I'm T too. Like, we're a bunch of T's around here. So, do tell the lovely Nell.
I am Tiara Neal.
Yes.
And
where are you from originally?
I'm originally from Maryland. Maryland,
okay.
But I went to University of Maryland, Miami.
Miami, yes. I was going to say Maryland.
Lake. No.
Where we met yes, back in 05 because we did the modeling thing.
Don't age me.
I didn't age you. I didn't.
I was in college, you know, that could age me a little bit. But we definitely did a fashion show together, which was fun.
Wonderful. Yeah, we fell in love. It's true.
I think that was one-sided, but...
Oh, yeah, exactly. Well, it's always...
We totally had fun.
Definitely had fun. I mean, it was unbelievable. I was excited to be there. Everyone thought that I was actually, like, this big Hollywood star because our friend, she introduced us as, they're from Los Angeles, they've been traveling all day, and everyone was like, Los Angeles, Hollywood.
Yes, we're all trying to get there.
And here I am, I'm like... I'm in Miami right now. I don't know about you guys. Like South Beach, I'm thinking South Beach, the beaches, the nightlife is unbelievable, the clubs, unbelievable. And I'm taken back by you guys. You guys are just unbelievable. Thought I was a superstar. And I was like, all right, cool. I'll just go with it.
And I pretended to think you were a superstar. I was like, yeah, this loser.
Yeah, exactly.
Just
and now she's on my radio show.
Right?
Yeah, see, that's how you do it. It takes time. It takes time.
It does take time.
But, like, time is what is of the essence. And, like, here we are again. I can't believe it.
Wow.
Has it been that long? 5 years?
That's scary.
And we still look good. We still look great. We look
better.
We look better. We look better. We look better.
Definitely more wiser than I was. Much more wiser than I was back at University of Miami.
Yes. And what did you? Okay. What did you do at the University of Miami besides model all the time? What did you study exactly?
I studied English and theater.
Theater, of course.
Theater, of course. That's why I'm out here in fabulous Hollywood pursuing my acting dreams.
And, yes.
You know, trying to dibble and dabble in other fabulous things that Hollywood has to offer.
So much. So much.
Yeah. It's
too much. Look at me. I have my own show.
The TT show.
Exactly. Exactly. Do tell everyone about the Mitch E.T. show.
I, when I came out here, I was working in fashion and acting and doing all this other stuff, and then I somehow fell into a wonderful project with a business partner of mine, Dave Drever.
Dave Drever.
He's the founder. I'm the co-founder, along with Ashley Noel.
Ashley Noel.
Jessica Lanthier. She's part of the company. She's one of the faces of the company. She's so beautiful. That's why we picked her. Fabulous personality. But the United with a Y. U-N-Y.
U-N-Y. Okay.
So this Generation Y females taking a bold stand against sensationalism in the media.
Wow, yeah. This is huge.
Yeah.
I like the female part. This is huge, yes.
It's huge. It's huge. Log on to beunited.com.
That's beunited.com. Don't forget it.
With a Y.
Not an I.
And we're also on Twitter at United.
Okay.
But yes, we really just want to make a difference, you know, even if it starts with one girl deciding not to praise Britney Spears for getting half naked and dancing on stage.
That never happens.
Praising somebody else who, you know, inspires her to, you know, choose education first and then all the fun stuff after, and just making a difference in the world, even if it's, like I said, just one girl at a time. That's what the United stands for.
I like that. So wait, this all came about at this last, when did you start putting the program in?
This has been going on for almost 3 years now. We're truly blessed. Like, honestly, we've moved mountains since then. We have Ellen Kay, who's a part of our team.
Ryan Seacrest. Did I say that? I know he's already thinking, no, that Mitchie T is the man, but you know.
But I'll let Jessica tell you guys what she does and how she contributes to the United and all her fabulous things, because I try to keep up with her and I'm like, shoot, let me look at her Facebook and check her pictures and stalk her.
I'm telling you, double trouble is hard to keep up with, because it's not just trouble, it's double. Double the trouble.
Well, thank God for Twitter and Facebook, because you can stalk people without them knowing.
Exactly, that's what I do. Stalker. Oh, do tell over here.
Well, I'm Jessica.
Yes, welcome.
I'm from LA, born and raised in Santa Monica, California.
Hey now.
Woo, shout out to Samo.
Yes.
Let's see, I'm not saying my age.
No, you don't. No, of course not. You don't say your age. Aries. Come on now.
Yes, I'm an Aries.
Okay, and I'm a Sag.
You're a fire sign. Yeah. Did you know that fire signs, we all get along?
That's why there's so much fire. There's so much fire right here in the studio, right here on the Mitchie T show. Only on the Mitchie T show. Yeah, exactly. We'll blow the spot right up. Like it's always in flames here, because it's always so hot.
So
yeah, I got double trouble. See, what can I tell you?
T squared.
I live in Hollywood, or West Hollywood. I'm a personal assistant for Jesse McCartney.
Nice.
Shout out to Jesse.
Jesse again.
In New York right now.
Oh, she's in the Big Apple. Okay, tell her to bring me back. I love you. I love New York. NY T-shirt, because I love those T-shirts. Yes.
Okay.
Yes, I want a T-shirt for sure. I'm a large, because I'm in charge. Definitely.
That's pretty much what I do out here. In addition to trying to maintain a social life and stuff.
Okay. Do you want to also do film just as well as who doesn't?
I did, not so much anymore.
Oh, not so much anymore. Because you're occupied doing
Jesse
other things.
Jesse has all my time. Yeah.
Ah, you take. Jesse has your time.
Assistant, it's
Most of my friends are personal assistants. I mean, trust me, I was a personal driver, and I was just, that was too bad. You know, that I had all my time driving. Like, what's going on here?
It's not bad. I mean, I love my job. I love it, love it, love it. I work for him and his manager, his business manager. And it's great. I love it. Right. I have the next week off while they're traveling the country.
Oh, yeah.
Going on radio tours. I'm not complaining.
And we're on a radio show now.
We're on
the
radio.
It's a tough life that we live here, right?
Just
here in Cali.
Just on radio shows. I'm doing mine.
Cali's tough. I'm telling you, it's really tough, like, to meet the people that you want to hang out with and do radio shows with. I'm telling you, it's really tough. So you two met, what, 2-3 years ago, of course? Y'all feel like you've known each other. Y'all look like sisters. Like, I'm
I feel like she's my sister from another mother.
Mister.
Yeah, mister. I want to be from another mister.
Yeah, definitely. You
know, especially out here.
But we met, like...
I think it was meant to be. I really don't even... I don't know the story behind
it. I ran into her one time in the bathroom at
Teddy's. The tea room on Monday?
And we were like, wait, I know you from somewhere. Remember? We had that whole moment. And then maybe, like, what? 6-7 months later, we kind of
reconnected
just like organically through a mutual friend, and her and Dave wanted to meet me to do the United, and after that, I think it was just match made in heaven.
It's just like when we met in Miami 5 years ago, and then we met last year doing the stairs. I tend to work out the stairs in Santa Monica, of course. Like, boom, it's like you had this chemistry. It's like you can always be found, not just on Facebook.
I have that energy. I think
exactly.
I'm just drawn to her.
You do.
I'm not gonna lie. Good people are drawn to me, and I'm really blessed because.
Well, I'm not good. I'm great. Come on now.
great people.
Fantastic,
great
wonderful people.
Are drawn to me, and I'm so fortunate that, you know, I know how to weed out the bad ones in a split second.
We don't like the rotten egg.
We don't like the bad ones. And when we do get a bad one every once in a while, you just got to cut them loose. My friend said earlier today, she's on a people detox, getting rid of all the bad people.
I like that.
Shout out A. Simmons for that one.
A. Simmons. Hey, I like that.
Thanks for that.
So let's talk. Let's see here. Now, I want to see, what projects are you involved in right now? Are you allowed to say, did you sign a fat contract? Because everyone comes on my show, I send this contract, it's really huge, it's like this Dick Mitchell, I can't talk about it.
To be honest, I have been traveling.
To be honest, she's going to be honest with us, ladies and gentlemen.
I know, that's like...
That's very rare out here in Hollywood. That never happens in Hollywood. There's no honest people
honest,
out here.
But I'm not going to give all the details.
Details. You got to sugarcoat
right,
away.
You know, that's how we roll out here. Yeah. But no, I, for the past year, have been traveling with my fiancé, who...
Joey Gathright, Chopper, the Hiroki Kuroda, and... Whoa! Oh, look at Joey! Remember Liz Swan, the old ballad, the old superstar competition? She jumped over the high jump bar? It's kind of like that one right there. That's pretty good. All right, you must be able to dunk.
We about to jump over a car. Okay, let's go jumping. My boy Joey Gathright is about to jump over a car. This is the car we picked. It's got a little bit of running in it. It's a Gallant. So, check it out. See what we got here. He's going to jump the car. Oh my God, are you kidding me? Dude, he's gonna jump a beamer now. Hey, you got enough room? You're not gonna hit that car right there?
No, I have to stop.
All right, hold up.
You're gonna say what?
Hold up, you got the beamer now. Yeah, ready. There he goes.
I am the man.
He's a professional baseball player, and so I have...
What team?
He recently...
The Yankees?
Got released from the Orioles.
Oh, so you gotta say the Yankees. You gotta put like a good word. Like, Yankees.
Shout out to the Yankees, because my friend's husband plays for them.
Oh, okay, there you go. There's
Chad Godin, what's up?
So he was with the Orioles,
and
CC
Sabathia and his wife.
CC.
And AJ Burnett and his wife. Shout out to them.
Shout out to
these people.
Good friends of ours.
Yeah,
but,
that's nice.
You know, it's been a tough year for him, and he doesn't have a team right now, but you know, God willing, he'll get picked up in the off season.
He will. He's got a good woman by his side. See,
behind every good man is a fabulous woman.
Absolutely fabulous.
In great shoes.
Yeah, exactly.
Honestly, Richie T saw something in me. That's why I'm on his show.
Oh yeah, yeah. I saw many things. Many things. So what are the project? Yes.
So, you know,
enough about your husband. Come on.
No.
I don't want to jinx it. Right? Did you break something in the studio over there?
Probably my cell phone. That's okay. My iPhone for the 100th time. It's okay. Whatever.
She's fine.
But like I said, you know, I've been traveling for the past year, so I haven't really been devoted to my career and to the United like I would want to be. But
that's because you're in love. Look at that ring. Oh, let's look at the rock. Oh, well, whoa. Sparkled city.
Yeah,
that's why you're star stunning now, see? Boom, boom.
It's amazing how that happens, yes. Right? But, I got back to LA literally a week ago, and I'm already on your show.
Yeah.
And, you know,
it's crazy.
At the United, I'm definitely plugging the United. I'm plugging away, taking meetings, trying to maybe, you know, produce a TV show for us. And, you know, it takes a long time to get anything fabulous
yes,
off the
does.
Ground.
It
really does, and it's such a process. But I'm very fortunate to be a part of the United. So really, it's just plugging away and trying to get
Do tell more info about the United. Like, where can we find about the United?
Like I said, you can log on to beunited.com, okay. Where Ashley Noel is blogging every single day. You can male or female can be a part of it.
Nice.
Shout out to Ning. They're the ones who are doing our website. And Twitter at United.
Twitter.
Remember,
nice.
UNYTED. And I'm at United Tierra. And
okay.
She's at Just the Besta.
Just the Besta.
Just the Best.
Duh.
Duh. Wow.
Duh.
How come I didn't think about that?
Duh.
Just the Best. Duh. Like, wow.
That's great, right?
That's fantastic. You have a really good nickname. So
she's pretty famous just by her name. Like, people are like,
she's
oh,
she's...
that's Just the Best. Duh.
Yeah.
I'm serious. Like,
exactly.
People worldwide are like,
fair
just
warning,
the
though. If you call me Just the Best anything in public, I will look at you like you have poop on your upper lip.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. That's not good. We don't like shit.
Step away from the computers, guys. This isn't reality. Like, it's just technology.
Yeah, no, yes, I like that.
You
that's
know,
good.
People still, you know, go for walks in the park and...
Yeah, exactly.
Go out,
you know,
and
people use payphones every now and then.
That happens.
If someone goes for a payphone,
let me tell them.
I would love to do a photo shoot.
Like the photo booth, like the straight up photo booth. Yes, that's like not a photo booth. I mean a phone booth. Right, what am I doing?
Phone booth.
Photo booth.
phone
booth. Yes.
Like none.
Unless you're, you know, watching Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure,
yeah.
And then that's about
that's
it.
A whole other story.
Yeah, exactly.
We don't have enough time for that conversation.
We always have enough time. This is the Mitchie T Show. I still time when I got this. Exactly.
And when you're out of time, you still go.
Yeah, exactly. Jesse, do tell us, where exactly are you from?
Santa Monica. Born and raised.
Born and raised straight up Santa Monica. Did you do any school, any like training?
Yeah, I went to Franklin Elementary School.
Franklin, hey, big cow.
I went to Lincoln Middle School. Shout out to Lincoln Lions. Santa Monica High. And then I went to Cal State Northridge. I'm not shouting them out because I hated that.
Whoa. no shots out.
I don't like the Valley, so.
Oh, the Valley. The Valley. That's another story. That's another story. For
Many
sure.
People in the Valley don't like going to the West Side, so it's kind of a
mutual.
But they hate each other. Yeah. Like, it's pathetic.
Yeah.
Just on the other side of the hill, people hate each other.
I know. It's just the 405.
Yeah.
But yeah, after Northridge, I went to Arizona. Hated Arizona.
That's Arizona, wow.
Yeah, that was really dumb.
You couldn't wait to get back to Los
Angeles.
I'm telling you.
Just not the Valley.
Just not the Valley. The most
exactly.
fun people had, or at least the most fun I had in Arizona, was going to Target at like 3 a.m. It was
Target at 3
hours.
In the morning.
Shout out to Target.
Let me tell you, Arizona has the most awesomest Targets and Walmarts ever.
Really?
Okay, well, I like Walmart. I mean, you can't go wrong with Walmart.
I bet you've never heard of a Greatland Target.
What?
Greatland Target.
Greatland Target.
It's like a whole nother version of Target. It's like there's a supermarket. There's like four times the size of a regular Target. It's huge.
Four times.
Yeah,
that's
super Walmart.
It's a super
They have crazy stuff out there. Yeah, it's
happening. I gotta hear a story after.
Yeah, my best friend and I, we would go at like 2, 3 in the morning and just get a car.
After the club? Yeah. No. Yeah, of course there's no clubs.
They carry guns, like, you know, probably Arizona. As long as it's showing.
No, it's just like in Texas. Like, it's straight up, like, people will come in the bank and, like, with the gun. I'm like, this is a bank, you have a gun. Like, yeah. I'm a little,
You get a little uneasy,
right?
You're
take my $5 out and try to deposit my, yeah, my $5. So. Yeah, I didn't ball it, you know. Like, ball because I had no money. Balling, crying. Not balling yet, but, you know, it's going to happen.
That was as far as school went. I think when I moved back to LA, I realized that school just wasn't for me.
And then now you're like, heck, I'm just going to get into the industry somehow and, like, get my foot in the door.
Modeling and acting.
Oh, see, now this is another story. Modeling. How long have you been modeling for?
Well, I used to model. I don't do it anymore. When I was younger, when I was like between the ages of like 4 and 11,
okay,
I modeled and did a lot of commercials, like Gap commercials. I did Sesame Street. I did
Sesame Street. Shout out. Who doesn't know Sesame Street? Come on, if you don't know Barney and Sesame Street, you need never. Don't even listen to me anymore.
Burton Ernie, Burton Ernie, yes. Find yourself.
Yeah, exactly.
But yeah, I did all that when I was younger, so once I moved back, I kind of got an itch for it again, so.
Yeah, you started itching, like, I got a little, get in there.
It creeps up on you.
As well as modeling for you, right? How long have you been doing any modeling lately?
Same as Jess. I started modeling and acting. My parents used to own a company out of New York called Kids Camera Action. I know, random, right?
Wow, in New York.
Kids Camera Action. My whole family was in the business, so I was kind of in it by default. But I booked my first national commercial at age 5.
Doing what?
Gosh, you're going to die.
Oh,
it was with the George Bush Sr.
Oh, wow.
Yes, the only good Bush.
The United Negro College Fund. And it was, mine is a terrible thing to waste. And I literally got to say what I wanted to be when I grow up. And I was like, when I grow up, I want to be a doctor. So then
you were lying.
Pursuing my
dreams in Hollywood.
Yeah, exactly. But who would have thunk it? But I had a local newspaper when I was 5 years old come interview me. And they were like, little Miss Tiara, what do you want to be when you grow up? You know, you say in the commercial you want to be a doctor. Is that true? I'm like, yeah, I want to be a doctor one day. And then the next day I want to be an actress. And then the next day a doctor again and keep switching off. And when they asked me, why do I want to be a doctor? Quote unquote, I said, people die, you know? And in the newspaper, and to this day, I have that article. And I still love
Do you have it framed? Like, do you have it framed? Oh, that's the best little article. People die, you know?
I mean, at age 5.
Hey, and like, honestly, she's pretty smart. I'm right? Like,
well, yeah, you right.
Hey, you right. Right. Yes.
Touche.
Yeah.
But yeah, so, you know, I stopped acting once my parents stopped.
They're like, this is not for you. You need to go back to being a doctor.
They let their company fold, and my brother, I'm the youngest of 5, so.
The youngest of 5, wow, big family.
Huge.
Gosh, and popping the kids out. Like, way to go. Congratulations to your mom and dad. Let's give them a round of applause because that was amazing. 5 kids. Tyrion and Nat and Neil, yes. I'm going to come over. You guys cook me some dinner. Great. You guys owe me.
But yeah, long story short, I quit the business when I was 5. You know, quitting the business. That's crazy.
Quitting the business at 5.
You know, I retired. I was SAG eligible at 5, and I didn't even know what that meant at the time.
Yeah, of course not.
I was a little athlete. I started running track.
Nice.
I was on the Olympic development program team for Maryland, and I know, right? Wow. For soccer. And I was playing basketball. I was just really athletic, and I...
Then you went to Miami, because that was the smartest thing to do.
I went to high school, and I'm like, wait, I want to be an actress again. Like, that seems like a lot of fun, you know? And then I went to University of Miami, and I was like, okay, wait a second. I want to produce. I want to act. There's so many things I decided I want to do. And when I got to Hollywood, it was like, whoa, this is a really big place.
It's another ball game out here. It really is. It's absolutely another ball game out here. Everyone knows somebody.
It's intimidating, and I'm just blessed to be doing what I love. I'm an actress. I'm a semi-working actress, but not really. No, I am a working actress, and yeah, let's just put it that way. And co-founder of The United, and I like
The United program, which is going to be an excellent program. Woo. And we just want to give all, go ahead and give some shout-outs out there, because I want to give a shout-out to my friend out there, Caesar. I know you're listening. He said he called me today. I'm going to be listening. Give me a shout out. Yes, it's all about you, Suze. You're going to be coming on my program shortly. You're going to hatch out of your egg for being so shy. And you're going to be coming on.
I'm going to shout out Dave Dreamer, my business partner.
Ooh, oh,
Dave.
Dave and Ashley Noel.
Yes.
My mom, Nanette Neal. And
oh, where are your parents living at right now?
My parents.
Back in New York still?
I'm going to bring up a sensitive subject. But my parents just recently separated after 30 years.
Wow, 30 years.
But my mom is in Wisconsin, my dad is in Maryland. Ish happens, way to bring that up.
Yeah.
Anyways,
way to go, Mitch.
Hey, this is the Mitchie T Show. It's more than just music. It's more than just radio. This is the Mitchie T Show.
Lastly, I want to shout out my fiance, Joey Gathright.
Joey? Joey, my man.
Joey!
Lucky guy, right?
No. Yeah, he's a very, very, very lucky guy. And guess what? You're going to have to get me like in the dugout. You're going to have to come through. You owe me too.
You owe me too. Get some tickets.
Exactly. Some tickets. Tickets are good.
I want to shout out... oh, man.
Wow, yeah, so many people.
Hold on.
Where's your... Like,
looking at my BlackBerry. I wrote this down on the way over here while I was remember everybody. Okay. So, no, I'm joking.
Okay.
definitely my mom, Vivian Lanier.
Yes.
Aaron Fields, my best friend. Mir Harris, another best friend. Angela Simmons, great friend. Tiara, of course. My whole United fam. Veronica, Dave, Adam.
Veronica, yes. Veronica, you're going to be coming on the show.
Veronica, bring your butt to L.A.
Yes.
She's in New Orleans, so we got to get her back.
Yeah,
we're gonna bring her back. Like, this show is going to bring her back. Like, exactly. I can cast her back over here. Exactly, straight up. Better than Ryan Seacrest.
Yeah, I have way more.
Way more, yes. Keep coming.
I'm going to shout out
my Alex Spot. Oh, my God. Are you listening? Which I totally told you to listen, but if you're listening, hey, girl.
Yes.
Lastly, I want to shout out my photographer, Anna Ochoa. Her work is phenomenal. Go to Anna Ochoa.
She doesn't have to work that hard, right? Come on.
No. She is amazing. I definitely want to shout her out.
Perfect. And AJ. And Kayla. Jenna, Sarah. Who
okay, we only have a 30-minute program here.
and me.
Yes.
And I think I'm done.
This has been amazing.
I'm going to shout out my sister, Chesmin, and her boyfriend, who are in Shanghai, China. I'm jealous.
They're in Shanghai?
Yeah, and my niece, my goddaughter, Charlie.
Gosh. Wow, like, this is unbelievable. Like, we're definitely going to have you guys back, because this is so much energy. Like, we didn't even have to play music today.
I know.
I didn't even play DJ.
We didn't even play Cascade or Sketch Show.
Cascade, Tiesto, Deadmau5. There's so much.
Right? Jesse's new single that's on the radio now.
Gosh, it's okay. We will.
You guys check that out. It's called Shake.
Shake?
By Jesse McCartney. You guys love it.
Yeah.
You'll love it.
We'll have that on my program, of course. We're going to have you guys back. Go ahead and say goodbye to Los Angeles, Hollywood, and the rest of the world. Because you guys, you know, it listening out there.
Bye, Hollywood.
Okay. It was an excellent, excellent program. As usual, with me, your favorite DJ, Mitchie T, every Thursday at 6:30. You know, it's all going to be right here, because you know it's more than just music. It's more than just what? Radio.
Radio.
It's the what?
Mitchie T Show.
Yes. Woo-hoo. And give us some kisses. Blow some kisses. Yes.
Be united.
The United, yes. Check it out.
Yes.
Check everyone out. United, you know, plug us in. YouTube us. You can find us right here. At where? Every Thursday at 6:30. Don't forget. Good night, Los Angeles. Give some kisses.
Good night.
Bye.
Love you, Hollywood. You're so good to me and Jess.
Yeah.
And especially to me. Good night.
Bye.
Excellent show again, Jess.
That's awesome.
You don't have.